Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, I'm Dr. Shemmassian, and for over 15 years, I've been helping students get into schools like UCLA, Stanford, and Harvard. Today, I'm going to tell you what MCAT score you need to get into medical school. After achieving a high GPA and dedicating hundreds of hours to extracurricular activities, you might feel like your med school chances completely hinge on your MCAT score. And you have good reason. In a 2015 survey of medical school admissions officers, MCAT total score received the highest mean importance rating of all application components after GPA. So given its importance, let's discuss how the MCAT is organized, why it's important, and how to achieve the necessary score. The MCAT is a grueling 8-hour test comprising four sections: biology, chemistry and physics, psychology and sociology, and CARS, or reading comprehension. It's graded on a 472 to 528 scale with a median score of 500. Most medical school programs require an MCAT score to be considered for admission. There are a few reasons why admissions committees weigh your MCAT score heavily. First, the MCAT is a standardized test, which enables reliable comparison of all applicants. One of the limitations of using GPA as a metric for comparison is it doesn't account for differences in major or undergraduate institution. For example, a 3.9 earned as an art history major, while impressive, is not viewed in the same light as a 3.9 earned as a physics major. Similarly, a 3.7 earned at Princeton will carry more weight with admissions committees than a 3.7 from, say, Penn State. Secondly, in a recent study conducted by the AAMC, correlations between total MCAT scores and performance in the first year of medical school were medium to large. And if you're an admissions officer, your job is to identify and admit the students who are most likely to be successful in your program. To answer this question, let's take a look at data provided by the AAMC. Here's the average MCAT score for all medical school matriculants, or students who were accepted to and enrolled in an MD program over the past 3 years. In 2016 to 2017, that average was a 508.7. 2017 to 2018, a 510.4. And in 2018 to 2019, it was a 511.2. The first thing you'll notice when looking at this data is that most successful MD applicants typically achieve an MCAT score at or above the 75th percentile, so a 507 to 508 plus. The second thing you'll notice is an upward trend. The average MCAT score among matriculants is rising, which means med schools have higher academic expectations than ever before. However, keep in mind that there's significant variability in average MCAT scores across all med schools. For example, a 511 would be competitive for Eastern Virginia, but too low for Stanford. Therefore, I highly recommend that you view the average MCAT of the schools you plan on applying to here. Your target MCAT score should be within a few points of the average. And if your score is significantly higher than your target school's average, you'll want to get specific about why you have chosen to apply there in your written materials. Some med schools may protect their yield rates and are careful not to admit students who seem unlikely to attend. Conversely, if your score is more than 3 points lower than the school's average, this school may be a reach for you. So how can you achieve your target MCAT score? Most students spend several months preparing for the MCAT, but the most successful students dedicate as much time to studying test strategy as they do learning test content. Earning a high MCAT score is tough, but success on the exam can have a tremendous impact on the competitiveness of your application. Through dedicated preparation, you'll be maximizing your chances of being accepted to your dream school. If you found this video helpful, hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you can do that here so you don't miss out on new videos. And if you'd like to learn more about med school admissions, you can also click the link in the description to get a free copy of my book, How to Get Into Med School, which contains all of the strategies we use to help students get into schools like UCSF, Northwestern, and Emory. Again, thanks so much for watching. See you next time.